Hello students, today we are going to start with 64-bit programming. So as an introductory part, we'll start with how to write some basic code using 64-bit programming. So basically we will consider all the programs in 64-bit assembly language, as well as whatever instructions we are going to use, they will be compatible with the 64-bit. So to start with, we'll just see an example of hello world like we see for every programming language. So basically this assembly language program consists of different sections. So what these sections are? So like one of the sections is section.data. So this is something where you can initialize the variable with some values. Like these values will not change during the execution of the program. So here you can declare a variable with some value. Those can be the constants. Other section is something called as BSS. So BSS is where you can declare the variable, but you cannot initialize any value to it. So you just know the name of the variable and the total size of the variable. And third, which is main section, and it is called as text, where you actually write your instructions. And from that your execution begin. Okay, so now we'll start with writing those section and how to use that. So very first, here I'm going to use the order. First we will write the data section, then BSS section, and then we'll write the text section. So let's start with the sections. So this is data section. This is the syntactical way to begin your section. Now here, if I want to initialize any variable, let's say I want to initialize the variable with name msg, message, one of the message I need to display, and that message content will be, this is my first 64-bit program. So here name of the message, that variable, then size, how much size it is going to take. Now here d and b, it stands for, d stands for define, and here b stands for your bytes. So whatever the individual element of your variable, it will be of 1 byte. Then we'll start with the content, whatever value I want to assign to that variable. Suppose I'm going to write hello, this is my first 64-bit language program. So this is something of value of that variable. Okay, so you can correlate it with the character string in higher level programming language, as this assembly level deals with the low level programming language. So along with this, you need to work on the size of that variable as well. So here we'll see how to calculate the size dynamically. Now if I want to calculate how many characters are there, then one of the possible ways is like, I will start counting from this edge and will continue up to this M, including all these white spaces, any special symbol in between this double quote. So this is something from H to this last M is called as total size of that variable. So let's see how to calculate it. Suppose I will calculate it and I will store it into some other variable, because we'll require it at the time of instruction use. So for storing the size or that length, I will declare one variable called as msg length. Here I will use keyword equals and some syntax which will help me in calculating this length of that variable. So this dollar dash followed by my name of the variable will help me in calculating total character count of this variable, and it will store it into this msg length variable. So it is something, this is equals to whatever character count is being calculated. So this is a sample variable which you can declare as a part of dot data. Then we'll see how to write the text section, because here we are not going to use any variable which can be part of the BSS. In very first program, it is not required. So now we'll directly start with the main section, that is your section.txt. Now here you should have some starting point. Like in higher level programming language, you have function called as main. From that main only your execution starts begin. So here the same function is being, or same is being taken care by this underscore start label. Now label is something to group some of the instructions which can be related together. It is just like a naming that group of instruction with some unique name. So this is something, a default label. From this your compiler will interpret that instruction needs to start execute. Okay, so now we'll just see what we want to do. Our target is to display this content onto screen. So for that we'll require some write function. So like in higher level programming language we have printf, scanf, like this functions. So here we need to have some different strategy. Okay. So we'll start writing the instruction. Now this first move RAX, 1 is something, this is a system call for writing. So now what is system call? This system call starts from number 0, that is a decimal number. So 0 to, it will go on, like we are using 60 as well for exit. So system calls are helping us to do the specific task. Now here system call 1 is used to perform write operation. After that, so RX is the register in 64 bit we need to use to define our system call. Then second is move RDI, 1. Now this is something, a file handle for calling stdout function, which will help us, so like on, which will help us to display this content of MSG variable onto the output console. So this you can consider as a file handle. Again it is 1, which is for stdout, which will help you to display the content onto the console. Okay. Now we know what we need to do, that is write operation, where we need to write on the console. Now what we have to give to the program, that what, from where, means what content should be written and what is its length. So for that we can write the instructions like RSI, this. It means I need to display the content of this variable, so I have passed the address of this variable, because here I am directly writing the name of the variable, and RSI is our indexing register. And next remaining thing is I need to provide the size or length of that, and that's why we have calculated at the time of, sorry, here it should be message, and that's why we have calculated at the time of writing the data section only. So what we have done up till now, in this line we have initiated the write function, then stdout. So you can call this first instruction we have written to just initiate what type of operation we need to do. Second, this instruction we have written to where actually we need to write it, using which function, and then which is the variable and what is its length. After that we need to use our instruction called a system call. So what it will do, it will invoke the it will tell operating system to do the above stated operations, what we have done. So what we can say, that it will tell your operating system to do the write operation. Okay, so this is a line of code starting from number 11, line number 11 to this 15, which will help you to display the content. Now in every program we need to successfully terminate the execution. So similar way we need to do it here as well. So again, for the same we have system call for doing so. Okay. So 60 is the system call to exit from the whatever execution mode is going on. And then this is something 0 to pass or to return code 0, means while when you terminate your execution you should return with a code 0, so there should not be anything on your console. and then again whatever you have written that needs to get executed. Okay, so this is simple program where you want to display a message. Let's check whether it will work or not. So we'll try to run the program. Yes, so we get the output, whatever message we have passed through the variable, and we exited with code. So this is not a part of the output. This is because we have put that RDI value 0 in our exit, and this is our actual output where we have displayed, yes, this is my first program.